So we're here at the IDTechEx. So who are you?
My name is Jim Hunter. I am the chief scientist with Greenwave Systems.
What is Greenwave Systems?
Well, in a nutshell, Greenwave Systems is an ingredient company. That means we sell business to business, who then sell to consumers. So we have products and spaces around IoT that include network and routing. We have products that are partnered through Verizon. We have products that are lighting that are on the store shelves at Home Depot and Lowe's through our partner TCP. And we have energy management products that are operating in Europe today.
So there was a panel discussion right now, and what did you say?
I thought it was actually a good panel discussion. I think what we came to the realization was that to monetize this, we actually have to go through a growth cycle. And I think that we understand that where we are in the growth cycle is we're kind of at the, a friend of mine from Samsung actually said it very well, we're at the peak of expectation and we're about to fall into the trough of disillusionment. But I think that what that narrows down to say that the consumers are given a little bit of pushback to what is today the IoT, which is a lot of crowdfunding companies and a lot of companies that are kind of pushing solutions into the market like connected forks. And what's going to come from that is learnings that we can actually make real viable commercial products.
And so there's been Internet of Things for a while, right? You've been doing stuff for a while, right?
Over 22 years, yeah.
But is it going to be like a trillion-dollar industry?
It's absolutely going to be more than a trillion-dollar industry. And the reason for that is because IoT is a very broad spectrum. In fact, they're even having to segment it for discussing purposes between IIoT, Industrial Internet of Things, and the regular IoT. Generally, we talk about IoT, we talk about kind of the evolution of home automation, smart home, connected cars, but there's a much bigger world in the world of sensors. And sensors connecting to the network and the ability for that to improve processes and improve interactions between things and things between people and people between their data and processes, that's where the money's going to be.
So you're the chief scientist?
I'm chief scientist and technology evangelist.
What does that mean?
That means I am actually overseeing technology and intellectual property. But at the same time, I'm also weighing in on marketing and helping to evangelize the message of IoT to the world.
So what do you think about IDTechEx, this conference?
This is a really good conference. There's a lot of really interesting technologies I'm interested in here. Graphene and 2D technologies, I think, are key. Material science in general is fundamental to actually changing the technology and evolving technology so that we can get smaller, better, faster, and less power-hungry things.
This is a conference where it seems like fundamental science is getting productized. Like some of these things people have been talking about or trying to mass produce new printed electronics.
Absolutely. Printed
get
electronics.
The price down.
Absolutely. Well, that's what you have to do to get it to the mass market. You have to get the price down. But, I mean, let's not forget that it's only a few years. I believe in 07, 09, was the Nobel Prize for Graphene was awarded, and we began 2D technology development. So we're not very far down this road. We're moving very, very quickly. And I love what we've got is we're kind of hitting critical mass with a lot of these technologies because they're going to solve so many problems. It's not just about making things that are more electrically conductive. It's actually graphene is one of these super materials that also solves conductivity problems as well as strength, as well as durability. All kinds of challenges get met in one single solution.